पप्पा
Yesterday we finished one problem and today we will be starting with the next one. Hope you have understood the first problem which we discussed yesterday.
Yes.
Very good. So today we will be moving towards the second problem which you can see there. And even I asked you to just mark down which are current assets and which are current liabilities so that we can solve it very easily. So starting with second one, following is the balance sheet of Fergana Company Limited as on 31/3/2018. They have given balance sheet as on 31/3/2018. And they have given equity share capital, 8% debentures, profit and loss account. These all are not related to us. Yesterday only I said you should mark wrong mark in front of them to indicate that they are not useful to us. Then next is bank overdraft, creditors and provision for taxation. All these three are current liabilities. You can mark in front of them current liabilities. Next is buildings, stock. These building should not be considered because building is a fixed asset. So that's why it should not be considered. And next is stock, debtors, cash in hand and prepaid expenses. All these four are current assets. Okay, so that's why you can mark in front of them CA. आप कैसे लिख सकते हैं CA बोल के लिख दीजिए. इसका मतलब होता है ये क्या है, ये current assets है. Okay, then और आपको और एक चीज करना है. Stock के सामने जब आप one more thing what you can do is when you mark CA in front of stock, you also put a wrong mark उसके आगे in front of that. ಅದ್ರ ಮುಂದೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ, ಒಂದು ರಾಂಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಹಾಕೋರಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ, ರಾಂಗ್ ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುವಾಗ ಇದನ್ನ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸ್ ಲಿಸ್ಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದ ಟೂ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್, after writing CA, you put a wrong mark also. It indicates that it should not be considered while calculating quick assets. Now, let us start the solution. First, write the heading, calculation of liquidity ratios. Calculation of liquidity ratios. Okay, so in that the first one is see, this is how you need to write an examination also. Current ratio is equal to current assets divided by current liabilities. Current assets divided by current liabilities. Then next, number two, after leaving some three or four lines, you write quick ratio, or what you can do is you make a two line formula, that will be the better one. Quick ratio is equal to quick assets divided by current liabilities. Quick assets divided by current liabilities. After leaving four lines, you write the heading working notes. Working notes. And in that, you write current assets is equal to, in the current assets, we have totally four items. The first one is stock plus debtors plus cash in hand plus prepaid expenses. Now that will be, the stock is 1,26,000. Next, debtors is 90,000 plus cash in hand is 22,800 plus prepaid expenses is 7,200. So in total, I think it is 2,16,000 plus 2,46,000. Can you take the total and tell me whether it is 2,46,000 only?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is 2,46,000. Okay. Now, next is current liabilities is equal to, there are three current liabilities. Number one is bank overdraft plus creditors plus provision for taxation. So now, the bank overdraft is 60,000 plus creditors is 2,40,000 plus
6,000.
Provision for taxation is 6,000. So that comes to 3,06,000.
3,06,000.
3,06,000. Then next is quick assets is equal to. Can somebody tell me what is the formula for quick assets? I have already given it yesterday.
Current asset minus stock minus stock.
Yes, it is
current assets minus current stock minus assets. Yes.
Minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Minus prepaid expenses. We know that current asset is 2,46,000. You have ascertained it above 2,46,000 minus. What is stock here? I think stock is 1,26,000.
1,26,000.
Yes. Minus. The prepaid expenses is 7,200. 200. I think it will be 1,12,800.
Yes, sir.
Check up.
Yes, sir. 1,12,800.
Okay, 1,12,800. Done. So these are the three workings you are supposed to do. Okay. And once you finish, you can come to the problem because you have all the things which is required to solve a problem. So when I have asked you to leave few lines blank there. So current ratio, current assets divided by current liabilities, it will be 2,46,000 divided by 3,06,000. Can somebody tell me what will be the result?
0.8039.
Okay, then we can write here as 0.80 divided by 1, which is nothing but 0.8:1. Hope you are able to understand. Next is quick ratio is equal to quick assets divided by current liabilities. And the quick assets are 1,12,800 divided. Can somebody tell?
0.37, sir.
Okay.
0.37 divided by 1, which is nothing but 0.37:1. Understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next problem आपके लिए homework है, but you mark down which are current assets, which are quick assets. देखिए, stock, debtors, bills receivable, advance tax, cash, ये सभी current assets है. You can mark all of them as current assets from stock to cash. All are current assets. Okay. Next is from creditors to bills payable, bank overdraft, all are current liabilities. You can mark them as CL. Over. Then you put a cross mark in front of stock and advance tax, which indicates that while calculating quick assets, we need to ignore them. Done. Next, you come to problem number 4. There also, I request you to mute your mic if you are not speaking because background noise is disturbing a lot. Now, from the following particulars, calculate current ratio and quick ratio. Now, inventories, trade receivable, cash in hand, current investment. All these 4 are current assets. And next 3 are current liabilities. You can mark. First 4 are current assets. Then next 3 are current liabilities. Next. You put a wrong mark in front of inventories so that we can remove it. Okay, so this is also your homework. Now, next. From the following, calculate current ratio and quick ratio. That's a little bit simple problem. It is similar to the first one. There is a little change. Only three items have been given: current asset, current liability, and stock. Okay. So now, first, we know very well that he has asked us to calculate these two things. One is current assets and current ratio, and the other one is quick ratio. And the formula for current ratio is current assets divided by current liability. And both the items are already given in the problem. First, current assets, it is 2,40,000. Hope I'm right. 2,40,000 है ना शायद?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Divided by current liability, that is 60,000. Okay, 4,040 gets cancelled. 6,4,6,1,0. That leads to a ratio of
4:1.
Hope you have understood.
Yes, sir.
Next, quick assets divided by current liability in this. मैं यहाँ लिखा हूँ देखिए. Workings. We need to pull and get the result. That is, because it is equal to current 120,000, and so it gives us you have noted down this problem. सॉल्यूशन नोट किया है आपने?
यस सर.
नो सर, आई एम राइटिंग.
व्हाट?
यस सर.
ओके, नेक्स्ट.
नो सर.
Even your 6th and 7th problems are also homework. Now, 8th problem is the replica of the problem number 2, which we have solved. So, no need to solve that problem once again. So now we directly move to problem number 9, which is a unique problem. Okay, because it is not like this easily taking the total and solving the problem. So it is little different. So let's discuss what that problem is. Okay. The problem says that the current ratio is 3:2 and working capital is 50,000. Okay. Remember, the current ratio is 3:2 and the working capital is 50,000. Calculate the amount of current assets and current liability. So first, in order to solve this problem, you should know first what is working capital. Okay, so first we will put the heading calculation of calculation of current assets and current liabilities. Current liabilities. Current assets and current liabilities. Okay, so now current assets is equal to current assets is equal to, or I will put it in a very different way so that you can understand. First, we need to understand what is working capital. Okay, what is working capital? First, let me put the formula and make you understand. Working capital. Wait for a minute. Now, working capital is the difference between current assets and current liability. What is the working capital? It is the difference between current assets and current liabilities. Now, what is meant by this? I will tell you. Your short-term assets are 10,000. Your short-term liabilities are 6,000. Or you can say your current assets are 10,000 and your current liabilities are 6,000. That means out of the 10,000, 6,000 is required to meet your liabilities. And remaining 4,000 you can use in your business for day-to-day operations. What is meant by this? Working capital. Okay. So hence, while writing the formula of working capital, we put it as current assets minus current liabilities. So current assets minus current liabilities. And yaad rakhiye, now they have not given us what is current asset and what is current liability, but what they have given us is the ratio is given. The ratio is the relationship between current asset and current liability, which is given as 3 is current asset and 2 is current liability, which means that the working capital is 1. The working capital is 1. So now the question arises, that is, this is called calculation of current assets. So what I will write, if 1, what is 1 here? 1 is working capital. You need to remember, 1 kya hai hamare liye? 1 is a working capital. So 1 is equal to 50,000, because you know that 50,000 is the amount of working capital which is available with us. So that's why when the 1 is equal to 50,000, then 3 is equal to how much? What is 3? 3 is current assets, and the problem asks us to ascertain the current asset. So that's why I write here, that is current assets is equal to 50,000 into 3 divided by 1. That will be 1,50,000. Yaad rakhiye. That is how much? 1,50,000. Then next is. This was first. The next is, if 1 is equal to 50,000, then 2 is equal to how much? What is 2? 2 is current liability. If the ultimate answer is, that is current liabilities. Liabilities is equal to 50,000 into how much? 2 divided by 1, that is
1 lakh.
1 lakh. Hope you have understood it.
Yes, sir.
And in order to cross verify what you have done, that is right or not, what was the formula for working capital? It was current assets minus current liabilities. Okay, so current asset we have ascertained it as 1 lakh 50 and current liability is 1 lakh. So just check what is 1 lakh 50 minus 1 lakh. It is 50,000. So again, it matches to our problems requirement, that is working capital is 50,000. And now when we deduct also, we are getting same 50,000. Done? Next. Problem number 10. We come to problem number 10. Honda Limited has an inventory of 20,000. What is mean by inventory? Stock. Stock is 20,000 and the liquid assets are 1 lakh. How much is the liquid assets? 1 lakh. And quick ratio is 2:1. Quick ratio is 2:1. And what you need to ascertain is, you need to ascertain the current ratio. Okay. So first what we will do, we'll write problem number 10. First what we need to ascertain, current ratio, we put it as priority and first we will write the same. Current ratio is equal to, current assets, divided by current liabilities. Current assets divided by current liabilities. Okay. Now, after leaving few lines, in this problem, we don't know how much is current asset and we don't know how much is current liability. But there are ways to ascertain current asset and current liability. Let us find the way. So what they have given, so I, leaving some lines, I come to workings part. In the workings, what I will write is, quick ratio is equal to quick assets divided by current liabilities. Quick asset divided by current liabilities. Hope you are aware of this formula. Humne use karke abhi kuch problem bhi solve kiye the. Now, what is the quick ratio which is given in the problem? The quick ratio given in the problem is 2:1. That is nothing but 2:1. And they have said that the quick assets are 1 lakh. The quick assets are 1 lakh. And we don't know what is current liability. So I put it as X. Because हमको मालूम नहीं है कि current liability कितना है. So we put it as X. So what will happen here? If we multiply, it will be 2X is equal to 1 lakh. 2X is equal to 1 lakh. Then X is equal to 1 lakh divided by 2. That will be 50,000. So current liability हमारा कितना है? 50,000 बन गया. So current liability is totally 50,000. Clear? Next. Now it's time to ascertain current assets. Now let's see. We learned a formula. This was working number 1. Now next is working number 2. We learned a formula, that is quick assets is equal to current assets minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Current assets minus stock minus prepaid expenses. Now in this problem, in the formula, what it says that quick asset is to be ascertained. But what we will do, we already have quick asset. We will ascertain current assets. So what is quick asset here? Quick asset is 1 lakh. Is equal to current asset. We need to ascertain. So I put it as X. And what is the amount of inventory? The amount of inventory is 20,000. And prepaid expenses is 0. Right? So then we can easily write X is equal to 1 lakh plus 20,000. That's going to be 1 lakh 20,000. Right? So how much we got? 1,20,000. So we got both the things. One is current liability. Right? So now, upar humne formula likhe waise hi chhod diya tha. Aage beti jo the formula par do. So formula is to current assets divided by current liability. Iga namu yeradu sikkedu. What is current asset? 1,20,000. And what is current liability? 50,000. If you divide, you will get 2.4 divided by 1, which is nothing but 2.4:1. Understood? All?
Yes, sir.
Yaro, no one hai talre. Ratio we had to ascertain, so that's why I have written the formula current assets divided by current liability. But both the things were not available in the problem. Hence, we need to ascertain the current asset and current liability. So, in order to ascertain current asset, what I did is, current liability, what I did is, I used the formula quick ratio. What was the formula for quick ratio? Quick assets divided by current liability. And quick ratio, we were already knowing. That is nothing but 2:1. So the same 2:1 I have written as 2:1. And quick assets was already given in the problem as 1 lakh. And what was missing? Current liability. That we need to ascertain. So that's why I put it as X. So when we cross multiply it, so 2 × X, it will be 2X, and 1 lakh into 1, it will be 1 So 2x is equal to 1 lakh. Then I ascertain what is current, how much? 50,000. Now the next duty was to ascertain current asset. In order to ascertain the current assets, because if stock everything was given, we would have directly added and ascertained the current asset. But no details were mentioned. Hence, I used the formula of quick asset. Because we were knowing quick assets and we were requested to ascertain current assets. So when I wrote that entire formula, I was knowing already that 1 lakh is quick asset and current asset we were not knowing. That's why I put it as X, and stock is 20,000 and prepaid expenses, as they have not given in the problem, we made it as 0. So that given us total 1,20,000, and we used this current asset and current liability to ascertain the current ratio. So that is 1,20,000 divided by 50,000. That gave us 2.4:1. Hope you have understood.
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
So tomorrow we will be starting with the next kind of ratios, that is solvency ratios. So aaj humne jo complete kiya tha, that is liquidity ratio. So we have finished with liquidity ratios. Now we will be discussing with solvency ratios tomorrow. Okay, so I request you that you solve the entire homework, right? And tomorrow I will check through video, because first around 10 to 20 minutes may go in checking your homework only. So I request you to have your notebook with you while checking the checking your homework. So please tomorrow be ready with your homework and be ready to learn new things. Okay, so thank you very much. Till that time, be in your home, be safe, and don't try to go outside, right? And I wish all the students who are keeping their fasting that God give you strength to keep your fast, and I wish that aapka jo Ramzan hai jo bahut bahut successful rahe. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
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 Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.